French Revolution. France is a nation of Western Europe. The capital of France is Paris. On the morning of 14 July 1789, the King of France, Louis XVI, ordered the troops to move into the city of Paris. Rumors spread that the king is going to order his troops to open fire upon citizens. Around 7,000 men and women gathered in front of town hall, formed people militia, and broke into a number of government buildings in search of arms. Several hundred people marched towards the eastern part of the city and stormed the fortress prison of Bastille, where they hoped to find hoarded ammunition. In this fight, commander of Bastille was killed and the prisoners were released, although they were only 7 in number. The fortress of Bastille was hated by all because it stood for despotic power of the king. The fortress was demolished and its stones fragments were sold in the market. Those who wanted to keep it as souvenir of its destructions purchased them and kept them for their memory. This incident was just a beginning of a chain of events. The final result of such incidents was the execution of the King of France, Louis XVI. Most of the people were protesting against the high prices of bread. To understand the causes of such incidents, we need to understand the construction of society of France in late 18th century. Let's understand what type of society was there in France at that time. In 1774, Louis XVI, who was from Bourbon family, ascended the throne of France. At that time, he was just 20 years old. He married to the Austrian princess Marie Antoinette. After his accession, he found the treasury was empty. The causes were several. Under Louis XVI, France helped the 13 American colonies to gain their independence from the common enemy, Britain. This war added more than a billion livres to the debt that had already risen to more than 2 billion livres. The lenders who gave that state credit, now they began to charge 10% interest on the loan. So far, the French government was obliged to spend an increasing percentage of its budget on interest payment alone. The high cost of maintaining an extravagant court at immense Palace of Versailles also added to the financial drain. The long years of war was also a cause of financial crisis of France. To meet its regular expenses, such as cost of maintaining an army, the court, running government offices or universities, the state was forced to increase taxes. Let's discuss the division of French society before the French Revolution. Before the French Revolution, the French society was divided into three states. First state, that includes clergy. Second state, which includes nobility. And third state, which includes remaining all. The first state was comprised of the church and the clergy. They enjoyed certain privileges by birth. The most important of these privileges were exemption from paying taxes. The second state was comprised of nobles and other rich people of the society. These were also exempted from paying taxes. They also enjoyed feudal privileges, which includes collection of feudal dues by peasants. The third state was comprised of big businessmen, merchants, court officials, lawyers, peasants, artisans, landless laborers, and servants. Within the third state, some were rich and others were poor. The peasants obliged the landlords by working on their fields, in their houses, to serve in the army or to participate in the building of roads. They were paying all direct taxes like tile and a number of indirect taxes on salt or tobacco, but had no rights. Let's understand some new words which have come in this chapter. The first one is Libre. Libre was unit of currency in France. This was discontinued in 1794. Clergy. It is a group of persons invested with special functions in church. Tithe. It was a tax levied by church. It was a religious tax. It comprised 1/10 of total agriculture produce. The farmers had to pay this tax to the churches. Tile. It was a direct tax levied by a state. This tax was also given by the member of third state only. In this way, third state used to bear the burden of first and second state in France. The population of France rose 23 million in 1715 to 28 million in 1789. This was a big increase in the population. Due to this increment in population, the demand for food grains increased rapidly. Production of grains could not keep the pace with increasing demand. So the price of bread, which was the main diet of majority, rose rapidly. Most workers were employed as laborers in workshops whose owner fixed their wages. But the wages did not keep pace with the rise in prices. So the gap between poor and rich widened. The 90% population of France was of peasants, and the condition of peasants were very critical, especially when drought or hail occurred. Their harvest reduced, and this situation led to subsistence crisis. Subsistence crisis is an extreme situation where the basic means of livelihood are endangered. People become unable to arrange the things of their basic requirements.